Hi guys, this is Nikhil Naka. Catch me on Unacademy Learning app for more awesome videos for your exam preparation. In the last two lessons, we were discussing about various aspects about ABCD parameters. What are they actually, how they are formed, what is their structure and how to find them, etc, etc, etc. Now let's proceed to enhance the understanding about ABCD parameters by doing some important model problems. So let's get started. So the first problem is, let me read out, if a power transmission line is modeled so as to relate VSIS to VRIR by the relationship VS is equal to AVR plus BIR, IS equal to CVR plus DIR, which of the following expresses the output impedance of the line? It was asked in IAS 2003. Okay, the options are, these are the options, okay. So, please note down the question and try to do the answer by your own. Now, let me explain this. So, it is given that you are having a ABCD parameters, okay, transmission line with this ABCD parameters, and you know all these things, these are quite easy things. Now, he is asking you to find the output impedance. So, what is output impedance means? Output voltage by output current. Similarly, input impedance means input voltage by input current. So, output voltage, output impedance is what you require. Output voltage is VR, input current is IR. So, VR by IR, okay. So, we know that VS, IS equal to ABCD, VR, IR. This matrix notation, we already know this. So, VS, IS represents the input impedance part, right? So, I will just keep VR, IR. I want VR by IR. So, I will put this on one side and I will transfer the ABCD on the other side. So, it becomes ABCD matrix inverse into VS, IS. You know, inverse of 2 by 2 matrix is 1 by AD minus BC, D minus B minus C minus A. And AD minus BC equal to 1 for a transmission line. We already know this relationship. What property is this? This is a reciprocal property. Hence, after solving, you get this matrix like this. So, VR, IR. Okay. You want VR by IR. So, just divide everything. You just put a line in between. That's how it becomes. So, your new output impedance is going to be, so DVS into BIS, the A is going to be your answer, right? You see, you just multiply VS into IS like this. You just multiply, you get the VR by IR. So option A is going to be your answer. Hope you understood. Let's do the next question. Now, after reading this question, you pause the video and do it on your own and then recheck your answer. Two identical lines having A equal to 0.9312 degrees, B is equal to 132 at an angle 72 degrees, C equal to 10 power minus 3, 90 degrees, and then D equal to 0.931.2 degrees are connected in parallel. The equivalent parameters is required. Now it's telling that it is two identical lines. Two identical lines means, I hope you remember the overall parameters of n number of identical lines. So, for any number of identical lines connected in parallel, A naught or D naught will be equal to the original value. So, A naught equal to A, that is 0.93 at an angle 1.2, D naught equal to D, that is 0.93 equal to 1 at an angle 1.2, and B naught will be B by N. What is the N here? 2 networks. So 132 by 2, so 66 at an angle 72. C naught will be N into C, here N is 2, 2 into 10 power minus 3 at an angle 90. So you just look at the options, then option C is going to be your right answer. Okay. Now, again, you just read the question and then pause the video and then again try on your own. In a three-phase transmission line with 132 kV at receiving end, the following are the transmission line constants, ABCD values, so and so given. If the load at receiving end is given as 50 MVA at 0.8 PF lag, determine the voltage, current and PF at the sending end. Okay. So, while doing such kind of problems, basically when you are dealing about a transmission line, a three-phase transmission line, this important thing, note, convert all line values into phase values. What are the line values? Line voltages are usually given. So 132 kV convert into phase voltage. Okay, it is given as receiving end voltage, right? 132 kV at receiving end. I want the phase voltage at receiving end, that is 132 by root 3 76210 volts. So always take receiving end as a reference. That means its angle is equal to zero. So, VR is equal to 76210 at an angle 0 volts. Also given that cos phi R, receiving end power factor is 0.8 lag, isn't it? So it is lagging, means what is the angle? -36.86, because cos inverse of 0.8. So it indicates lagging, therefore you are getting the minus. You are going to use the minus. I want to find what is the receiving end current. Receiving end current can be found by this relation. S is equal to root 3 VLIL. We know already this thing. Okay. I mean the apparent power in a three-phase circuit. So the receiving end apparent power is given. So 50 MVA is what you know. So your IR will be SR by under root 3 VR. Okay. You are just going to do with the line values. The reason is IR also you will be getting as line value. But IR line is equal to IR phase, because although not specifically mentioned, we will assume the entire system is connected in star. And you know in star, voltages are not same, line and phase voltages. That is, line voltage is equal to root 3 times the phase voltage, but line current equal to the phase current. So there is no problem there. So you proceed with this, you get the current 218.7 amps. So IR, when you write it in polar form, that is going to be 218.7 at an angle -36.86. -36.86. Why -36.86? Because its power factor angle is -36.86. What is basically this phi power factor angle? It is the angle between the voltage and current. So phi R will be the angle between VR and IR. If VR is at 0, then IR will be at -36.86, right? Because it is lagging. Now we can find what is VS equal to. A is given, B is given, you know, VR phase value, you know, IR phase value. We just put them. You get VS as 95371 at an angle 11.346 degrees. You have to convert this into line values, because the examiner expects you to, you know, write your answers in line values. So just multiply the magnitude into root 3, you get 165.187 something kV. Okay, the line voltage. Okay, sending end voltage in line value. Sending end current similarly, you just put on all the values, you get the IS as -196.88, -24.41 amperes. Okay, it's -24.41. So I want to find the sending end power factor also. Power factor is sending end power factor will be cos of IS, whereas IS is the angle between the sending end voltage and sending end current. So sending end voltage minus sending end current angle, sending voltage angle minus current angle. So the gap between both of the angles, I mean both of the vectors of sending end voltage and sending end current is 35.756. Put cos and then you get 0.8115 lag as the answer. Okay, this is how we can solve a transmission line problems using ABCD parameters when given. Now take the next question, the last question of the lesson. You just go through the question once and then pause the video and try the answer on your own and then look at the solution. A two-port resistive network has two input terminals A and B, output terminals C and D. The resistance is measured across AB when CD are first short-circuited and then open-circuited are 720 ohms or 1240 ohms. The resistance measured across CD with AB open circuited is 910 ohms. Determine the equivalent T network. The T network means which looks like this, isn't it? Now he said that AB are the, you know, input terminals, CD are the output terminals, and he says that this is a T network. So I am put and he is telling that it's a resistive network. So R1, R2, R3 I've connected in the form of a T, and he has given three cases. Okay. First case, he said that the impedance measured across AB when CD is short circuited. Now I am short circuiting the CD terminal. So I am short circuiting the CD terminals. What is the input impedance? That is nothing but R1 and R2, R3 are parallel right now. So R1 parallel of R2, R3, and he has given that value as 720 ohms. I will take it as a first equation. Now next case, he said that CD is open circuited. It was equal to 1240. And CD is open circuited, the input impedance is from A to B is simply R1 plus R3, because no current will flow into this, because this part is open circuited. So R1 plus R3 is going to be your case 2 equation, and this is equation 2. And case 3, he is measuring the impedance from the CD terminals with AB open circuited. So now this impedance is going to be R2 plus R3. So R2 plus R3 given as 910. What I will do is, I will subtract the second equation from the first equation. R1 plus R3 minus R2 R3. So R1, R1 get cancelled, plus R1 minus R1, then you get R3 minus R2, R3 plus R2 plus R3. R2 plus R3 value you already know. And also you can subtract on LHS and RHS side. So 1240 minus 720, that is equal to 520. Just multiply this R2 plus R3, and you multiply R2, R3 into R3. So R2, R3 plus R3 square plus minus R2, R3. So R3 square, okay, R3 square. See, R2, R3 plus R2, R3 minus R2, R3, both get cancelled. Okay. So then you get R3 square equal to 520 into R2 into R3, R2 plus R3. R2 plus R3 is 510, okay, 910. 520 into 910, then you get R3. Solve from this, R3 is equal to 37687.9 ohms. You got the R3 value, you can put it in this equation to get R2 value. You can put R2 value, R3 value in this equation. You can find R1 value also like this similarly. And you can proceed. Okay, and you got the all the values of R1, R2, R3. So that is what required values. Okay, R1, R2, R3. Okay, we found that equivalent T network. So hope you enjoyed watching this lesson and you learned some good things. Thank you guys. Keep supporting me by the way of recommending the course, rating the course, review, give 5 stars to the course and share the course with your friends. And if you have any more comments or if you are expecting something else from me, just put down in the comment box. I'll be attending to them. Thank you.